Okay, it's TLB time again. It's time for another speed draft, and it's me, Kim, here. And I've been drafting a lot, and I keep on drafting because I still like the format. Sadly, the first four picks, I had not started the program, but as you can see, we have a pretty promising start with Double Tribune Inspector, Sinister Concoction, Griff's Boon. And here, I'm going to pick Triska Decaphobia, a card I have not played with and probably not that much against, so we're going to go for it. I like a ghoul steed. We could get some self-mill and stuff. I guess we already have it with the concoction. And maybe some madness, who knows? And with Triska Decaphobia, I like trying to go aggro. It just seems like the best way to get in points of damage. So the deck could either just curve out and just win by that. Or if opponent stabilizes, they might be close to 13 life, and then you can drop Triska Decaphobia and maybe win that way. So it seems like a good plan B for an aggressive deck. So we'll see how it ends up. Vampire Noble seems like a fair 3-drop. We want a pretty low curve if this ends up being a Triska Decaphobia deck. So we might want to play, we will want to play some 3-drops. I don't like Unruly Mob, but if we get enough 1s and 2s, we might play it. Hoping not to. Yeah, same with Rancid Rats. It's not an aggressive card, but if we don't get enough other 2-drops, we might play it. But I do like, I mean, all the picks we have made so far, we could play. Devil Torn Fox is very good here. Aggressive and super with Griff's Boon. And I guess the resolve is not impossible that we're end up playing, but I'm going to put it in the sideboard for now. So first pack went awesome. And second pack has an awesome card, Tireless Tracker. Sadly, I don't think this is the time I'm going with the tracker. I want to try to stick on the Triska Decaphobia plan, and we already have a lot of good white cards for it. So the pick could just be a Murderous Compulsion to go with Sinister Concoction. So if we're ever in a spot where we're behind, we might get double value from the Sinister Concoction. Dauntless Qatar is the perfect 3-drop for this deck. As I said earlier, we might end up with some self-mill cards. Getting a flyer while after you have curved out aggressively could be the last points of damage. Ooh, another concoction. So looks like we might have... We already have 4 decent removal spells. And why not a third? I would like True Fate Sensor, but I am going to take... The concoction opens up so many possibilities for late Delirium pickups, late Madness pickups. They just increase in value. And this deck, after curving out, if we have a spare land or two, it does not mind just discarding a land for the concoction to be able to remove the last blocker and hit for lethal. This would potentially be a Toppleguys deck, but I'd rather just curve out with the Crow. And now we also have some self-milling going on together with Qatar and Ghoulsteed. If Toppleguys wheels, I might play it, but the Crow, if we're... I mean, white-black is not maybe not the aggro... color combination, but you can do it, and I think we are close to doing it here. Maybe we'll play a vessel if we really need delirium. Skeleton looks very good here because you could discard it to concoction, you could get it back if you self mill it. Yeah, I think that will be good here. Don't want to play an ox. We already have 17 playables and some borderline playables in the side. Could take the land here, but I do not mind one or two combat tricks in the deck, and strength of arms is good. And if we pick up a true fate sensor or something, we could get some extra value. Throttle seems a bit clunky. Behind the scenes, if there was a deck for it, this is probably close to it, but I still don't think that the card is that good. I actually tried it one of my earlier drafts, and I played against it, and it has never reached the potential I feel like it maybe can have. So I'm probably not going to main deck that card if I get better stuff to do with 3 mana. Survive the Night does not seem aggro enough. I would like to play +3/+1 and lifelink just to have a way of adjusting my life total if I'm going to try to win with Triska Decaphobia. Okay. Grief's Wound number 2 would be bonkers, but I'm weak to Angelic Purge as well. Because then we could also kill... Then we have 3 concoctions and an Angelic Purge, so and Murderous Command. So now we have 5 good removal spells, and now from now on we might just try to get enough creatures, I think. Heirloom would be decent, but I think I'm just going to pick a 3-1. On 3 right now, we have 2 good cards and the Vampire, which I hope maybe not. Okay, another Triska Decaphobia. Yeah, why not? I don't think I really need it in this deck, but it's fun. I played most of the color combination. Oh, Pious Avenger actually also helps me manage my life influence my life total. So I actually have 3 concoctions, a Pious, and nothing else right now. But there we have it. The Grotesque Mutation might wheel. But another Cathar, obviously. So now we don't need to play the vanilla Vampire. Humble the Brute might go in the sideboard. Yeah. I do think that card is best here. Probably not main decking a 5 mana removal spell, since we have so good removal. Okay. Yeah, Captain seems better than the Sensor, just because we have so many low drops. So, yeah, and Moorland Rifter is a 2-drop we like also, so might not have to play the Rats. Doesn't seem aggressive enough for this deck, and we don't need it as removal. I like Double Inspector and Skeleton. Grief's Boon will be super with our 3-1s and 4-4s and 3-3s. Might not even have to play 3 concoction if it seems like it's too bad, but we'll see. Just because we don't have, I guess, that much. We don't have any delirium despite the Drifter. I guess we could discard Ghoulsteed, Skeleton, or a land. Which means, yeah, and I do like another Fox. Because now we surely don't have to play the Rats, I think. Because we have enough 1 and 2 drops for this curve to be aggro. And I do like aggro as a base for our double Triska Decaphobias. Maybe the 2/4 flyer with a friend could be something we need to board in if we face blue-white flying tempo or something. So we already have 24, I think, pretty good playables. So, yeah, we got the mutation. I think we want to play that also, the one I was hoping to wheel. Okay, so we have to make... I think the deck looks very good. The curve looks very good. The Triska Decaphobia thing looks fun. I'm going to keep both of them in. I like all our spells, but we also need to have a pretty high creature count. We We do have some options in the sideboard also, with Puncturing Light, Rancid Rats, Humble the Brute, but what do I cut? This is a 16 land deck, I feel like, because it's very low to the ground and we don't mind staying on 4. So, and I do want to play Mutation more than Strength of Arms, and that's just because the value of being able to change my life total seems high. And even change opponent's life total. Let's say they are down to 9, attacks with a 1-1. They go to 13 and die. So that's also a fun trick. Let's see if I get to use it. So I think this deck looks awesome. It's one, power level wise, I think it's one of the better decks I've drafted in this format. I don't know why, but it just feels that way. Because this curve can also punish all the dirtly decks, I think. We need one more planes, just because the black is actually mostly needed to be played later on curve, but white, we really need to play that turn 1 Thraben Inspector, turn 2 Fox, for example. Skeleton can come later, Crow is later, Sinister Concoction doesn't have to be played on turn 1, and so on. So yeah, I think this looks super, and it looks very fun, so see you for a match soon.